Welcome to experiment A4. The aim of this experiment is to determine the sulfate concentration found in Epsom salt. This will be done by gravimetric analysis, and gravimetric analysis is a quantitative method for accurately determining the amount of a substance by precipitation from an aqueous solution. In this experiment, the sulfate concentration is determined by precipitation with barium to form barium sulfate. In the beginning of this experiment, you need to accurately weigh 0.5 to 0.6 grams of your Epsom salt, as shown in the weighing balance here, and record the value to 4 decimal places. After you have weighed out the salt, you can transfer this to a 400 ml beaker, and you can add some water to the weighing vial in order to transfer all the contents. This is followed by adding 20 ml of distilled water. And you can swirl this to mix the contents in the beaker. Ensure that the contents in the beaker are all dissolved before moving on and adding anything else to it. Once that is done, you can set it aside, and then you can move over to add in 6 ml of your hydrochloric acid and dissolving it in distilled water. To make it easier to transfer, we are going to add the acid to a beaker and then to our measuring cylinder. We then add this to our distilled water in another 400 ml beaker, and thereafter the contents of this beaker will then be added to the beaker containing our Epsom salt sample. Once this is done, we can then place it on a hot plate and we can heat it until near boiling. Please note that everything in this experiment must be performed in duplicate. In the next part of the experiment, we are going to add 100 ml of barium chloride solution, and we are going to heat this to near boiling. To make this easier to transfer, we are going to add it to a beaker before adding it to the measuring cylinder. Once this is done, you can plate it on a hot plate and you can heat this to near boiling. Once your barium chloride solution has been heating to near boiling, you can then add half of this solution to your Epsom salt sample. You can then cover your sample with a watch glass and you can occasionally stir it with a glass rod. Be careful not to do that too often, as this will disturb the precipitate. Leave this on the hot plate to digest for approximately an hour. While your solutions are busy digesting on the hot plate, you can ignite your glass crucible in the furnace for 15 minutes. When you do this, ensure that you label yours correctly so that you do not confuse it with somebody else's crucible. Once the 15 minutes has been completed, you can then remove the glass crucible from the oven. You can use tongs and a support so that you do not burn yourself. can then place this in a desiccator to cool, and once it has cooled, you can then weigh it in the balance room. We are now going to filter our precipitate, and we are going to do that by decanting out the liquid. And once we have the solid in here, we are going to rinse out the beaker with hot water. We are going to filter by connecting it to a pump, and that's what I'm going to switch on now. After you have poured out the solution from your sample beaker, you can then take out the crucible and discard this liquid. We are now going to rinse the precipitate with hot water. After you have rinsed with hot water, you need to test the washings with silver nitrate in a waste beaker. When you test with silver nitrate and it becomes cloudy like this, it means that some of your precipitate is still present. What this means is that you should rinse your precipitate with hot water until your washings is present as a clear liquid and not cloudy as this one is. We are now going to test the washings with silver nitrate. And as you can see here, the solution is not clear, which indicates that some of your precipitate is still present. You should wash your precipitate with hot water until the washing liquid is present as a clear liquid and not cloudy as this one is. After you have filtered out your precipitate, you can place your glass crucible in the oven to dry. When your precipitate has dried, you can then use tongs and a support to remove it from the oven and place it in a desiccator to cool. To end off the experiment, you will then take the cooled crucible and you will place it on a weighing balance in order to take the final mass of your precipitate and your crucible together. You will record your masses for each of the samples separately. You will use this information to determine the mass of sulfate, its average mass, as well as statistical data.